Whatever plastic bags you have, we are going to create a planter out of it, the macaram kind of a planter. So first thing, I hope all your bags are clean and dry. So your bags are like these. So just we will cut in the center. The bag, you have to cut in the center. Better to take the bag which has handle, and the bigger the bag, it will be easier for us. So cut it in the center. Once you cut it in the center, you get two bags like these, two pieces. Now, half part of the bag where you can see the handle, we are going to cut through this. And do it with all your bags basically, so that you can keep your bags ready. So what we are after, we need to get a loop like this. You see? We need loops like these. So, for the macaram, we are going to have three ropes. We need to create three ropes. For each rope, you will need at least six bags if you have large enough. If you don't have large bags, then you need to have even number of bags for each rope. So for me, I'm taking six bags for each rope. This way I will have three ropes and 12 bags. If your bags are smaller, if you want to have a bigger planter, plant holder, you basically do the maths and decide how many bags you need to have. But create the loops like this. A simple loop. I have two loops ready. So even for me, I do have some smaller size bags, some bigger size bags. If you have colorful bags, it will be even better because it will look beautiful, the color of your final product. Now by upcycling, we are actually, what we are doing is we are making a functional piece. We don't want to just create some art, because how many art you can anyways create out of waste, and how many art you are going to hang in your home. So better to create a functional piece. Upcycling through upcycling, so that you can keep on using it and extend the life cycle of these plastic bags. This is our goal basically. And obviously, if you are a plant lover, you would love to have a macaram plant hanger. So if you are creating on your own, you are reducing the consumer demand. You are not going to buy a new one. So that is another sustainable action we are going to do through this workshop. So I hope so at least one rope I want you to do with me. Actually, if you get the technique, it's super easy. It will be very good to do even with your kids, if you have kids at home. So all my loops are ready now, as you could see. You can see this kind of bag, like this kind of piece which is hanging out, but don't worry about that. I will tell you what to do with this sort of pieces, and still how our macaram plant hanger will look beautiful. This planter I'm going to use because I need to have a hook to create braiding like this one. So it's same kind of braiding which we do with our hair. The loop, what you see over here, try to make a loop or try to hide these open ends in such a way, cover them in such a way so that it will look like a entire endless loop without any hanging open ends outside. So wherever you are braiding, make sure that you will always insert the open end inside, roll it inside so that your final braid will look great. So we are going to now braid these bags. So three loops will be three separate use them like three separate partitions and start braiding them. I hope you can see it. Now when braiding, make sure that you are not really braiding it too tightly or too loose. Lot of plastic noise. Try to braid them as beautifully as possible. I hope you know how to braid. Basically, I might show here. So, I'm just giving one example here how to braid. So, this one is your fixed. You have three loops. Now, when you are braiding, treat one loop as a one part, another loop as a second part, and this is as a third part. And braid it. First goes inside, then second goes inside, third goes inside alternatively. Then again, okay. So first, then second, and then third. End of the plastic bag when the braiding is done. Leave some space and now bring the next bag. So what you are going to do, the loop of the next bag you are going to insert. I'll show you here. This is easier. So this is the loop of first bag. This is the second loop. You are going to insert and make a knot here. Just a simple knot. Okay? One loop to other loop. So, the same way you will add three more bags to three of your loops and create the braiding longer. Create three of such braids basically. So, if you are done with the first, you can start doing the second one. I used basically six loops, so three bags, then six loops here, three bags, and six loops again. Total nine bags I used for these three braids. Are you able to see them? They are again not exactly in the same height as well, but it doesn't matter because we can always do the cutting and things later on. This is how we are going to hang our planter. Yeah, this is the hanging end, the one exact one which we kept under the, you know, we basically used for hanging to create the braids. This is where we are going to hang it. What I will do, ideally, take all of them. Use either a thread or the same like me if you have a just going to create. Make sure that they are tied up together. Okay. And either what will be ideal is I'll put all of them under this stand again,